So in this video here students will discuss about indifference set and indifference curve. Okay, so before we start indifference curve analysis, or what is indifference curve, we better understand by using this schedule. So in this schedule we have taken two goods, number one apples and number two oranges. There are two goods we have taken, apple and oranges. So we have already assumed that consumer will spend his total income on good X and good Y. His total income he will spend on good X and good Y. Good X and good Y. Here good X is apples and good Y is oranges. Okay. So first we take combination A. If we take the combination A, in combination A he purchases 1 apples, 10 oranges. In combination B, he purchased 2 apples, 7 oranges. In combination C, he purchased 3 apples, 5 oranges. In combination D, he purchased 4 apples, 4 oranges. So in these schedule, it is clear that in every combination A, B, C, D, in every combination, his total satisfaction is same. Whatever combination ABCD his total satisfaction is same. If he wants to stay in A position or B position or C position or D position, whatever position he wants to take, his total satisfaction will be same. That means 11. Okay. So in this way we can say that if there is no difference of satisfaction among the points A, B, C, D, so among the points A, B, C, D, consumer is indifferent because all these combinations his total satisfaction is same. That means 11, 1 apple, 10 oranges give satisfaction 11, 2 apples, 7 oranges, satisfaction 11, 3 apples, 5 oranges, satisfaction 11, 4 apples, 5 oranges, satisfaction same 11. So that is why I am saying that the consumer is indifference across the combinations. So together this combination A, B, C, D is called indifference set. This is an indifference set. 1, 10, 2, 7, 3, 5, 4, 4. This is a combination points. First combination, second combination, third combination, fourth combination. So these are the combinations, and all these combinations together we say indifference set. Okay, now if we put these points in a diagram, suppose here we take apples horizontal axis and orange in vertical axis. So we take points 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 apples we have taken, and here it is 2, it is 4, it is 6, it is 8, it is 10. So what is our first combination? Our first combination is 1, 10. So this point is 1, 10. This point is called 1, 10, 1 apple, 10 oranges. Second point is 2, 7, 2, 7 in between 6 and 7, 2, 7, this point. Third is 5, 3, 5, this point. Fourth is 4, 4, that means this point. Now if we join these points, we get a curve. If we join these combination points, we will get a curve. and this curve will never touch both the axes. Okay, and this curve is called indifference curve. Why this is called indifference curve? Because each and every point on this curve will give same satisfaction. On this curve, each and every point, whatever point you can choose, will give same satisfaction or same utility, same satisfaction or same utility. Okay, whatever, if you can take this point, then it get the same satisfaction. If we take this point, same satisfaction. If we take this point, same satisfaction. If we take this point, same satisfaction. Whatever point you can choose, it will give you same satisfaction. And that is why indifference curve is a diagrammatic presentation of an indifference set of a consumer. So what is indifference curve? Indifference curve is a diagrammatic presentation of an indifference set of a consumer. Indifference set of a consumer. Indifference sets are 110, 27, 35, 44. These are the indifference sets. Why it is indifference sets? Because consumer is totally indifferent on these sets. Why? Because all sets are give same satisfactions. So that is why on these indifference curve, you will get always same satisfaction. Okay. Next, we will discuss about the properties of indifference curve.